Good morning, Madam Mary. This is our group presentation from the organizational behavior observations. We have done our observations at post office with our group members, and today we'll have three presenters for the presentations: me, Tan Maning, and my two friends, Oi Bei and Teo Wen Lin. As an introduction, the research is emphasized for the how the organizational behavior affects a workplace, and we will focus on two topics that related to workplace emotions, attitude and stress, and the communicating in a team and organization. The observations were obtained in one day at all branch of post office in Labuan, with the purpose of ensuring the accurate information is obtained. And next, I will introduce the second presenter, Oi Bei. We will continue present about the case study one.
Now I'm going to present case study one. The objective of this research for topic one are how the employees' emotions, stress level, motivation, social relationship between supervisor and subordinate affect their job satisfaction. Work satisfaction theories such as social interaction model, Herbert's two-factor theories, jobs characteristic model, Adams' theories, and superior subordinate communication. The first theory is social interaction model. Positive and negative emotions were found to be significantly related to overall job satisfaction. Employees of all branch of Post Malaysia Berhad in Federal Territory of Labuan have shown a good attitude and behavior during working time. The second theory is Herbert's two-factor theory. Herbert's two-factor theory, also known as dual-factor theory, which indicate that motivation factors are required to motivate an employee to better achievement. According to the two-factor theory, there are four possible combinations, which are high hygiene and high motivation, high hygiene and low motivation, low hygiene and high motivation, and low hygiene with low motivation. The employees of all branch of Post Malaysia Berhad in Federal Territory of Labuan have high hygiene and high motivation, which is the ideal situation where employees are highly motivated and have few complaints. The third theory is job characteristic model. Heming and Aldens proposed the job characteristic model, which is broadly utilized as a framework to study how certain job characteristics affect job outcomes, including job satisfaction. The employees have high level of skill variety, task identity, task significance, and feedback but low autonomy. The employees have a low autonomy because they do not have significant self-reliance, liberty, and discretion to plan out the tasks and determine the strategies of in the job. The following theory is equity theory. Equity theory suggests that if an individual thinks there is an inequality between two social groups or individuals, the person is likely to be distressed because the ratio between the input and the output are not equal. The employees of post office have equal working time and having same break time regard to the shift they are working on particular day. They show that there is no inequality between social group or individual and can conclude as the employees are satisfied with their job. The last theory is superior subordinate communication. Superior subordinate communications refers to the interaction between organizational leaders and their subordinates, and how they work together to achieve personal and organizational goals. There is a good and healthy communication between organizational leaders and their subordinates. This is all theories about case study 1. Now my friend Fiona Ling will continue with case study 2.
Now I'm going to discuss about case study 2. The objective for the research for topic 2, they have to explore the effect of cross-cultural, different gender among employees and interpersonal of employee in communication. We have three theories. The first one is non-verbal differences among culture. Next one is gender differences in communication. And lastly, improving interpersonal communication. The first theory is non-verbal differences across culture. Non-verbal communication is also known as body language that can be described simply as silent message or messages without words. Not only this, language is a purely human and non-instinctive method of communicating ideas, emotion, and desire by means of voluntary pronounced symbol. Throughout the observation, we observe that the postmaster always keep their smiling faces while handling the customers. And the officers are also very flexible, which they try to communicate with staff with different races by using different malgam to prevent misunderstanding occur between two parties. The second theory is about gender differences in communication. Gender refers to psychological and social manifestation of being male or female. There are differences by the social defined, learned, constructed, acculturated of sex, such as hairstyle, dress, non-verbal mannerism, and interests. Throughout the observation, we found that the gender differences are also developed in the use of distinct ways to communicate with customer, such as when they meet the older customer, they will follow their space by communicating their ways slowly, while the other hand, for the younger generation, they will keep up their space. Traditionally, women communication consistently involved in maintenance of social and emotional, and men consistently perform task-oriented roles. The last theory, which is improving interpersonal communication. Effective interpersonal communication depends on the sender ability and delivering the message across the receiver performance as an active listener. Active listener may maintain the interest and motivated to listen the information that speakers want to deliver to listener. As in the observation, in a post office at Bangunan Tanggawa, the female workers as an active listener, she started to evaluate the customer needs after listening the requests from the customer, and she tried her best to help the customer. Lastly, active listener may respond to the speaker after evaluating the receiving message successfully. As conclusions, the research also highlight about some possible issues regarding the job satisfaction and communications as a team in the workplace. Some of the issues are employees have no efficiency of work, bad emotion control, and worse communications between comrades and customers. Lastly, improving interpersonal communication is not only increase effective and efficiency of work, but also build a suitable and comfortable working environment for employees. That's all for our group, and thank you for lending your ears.